So again, you can see on your screen that purple side has pretty set staple bands, Ryze, Echo, and Kalista. We'll see if those come through again. UP actually going to change it up, prioritizing that Yasuo ban. And again, the brilliance of this ban against King in particular is that it's a big pick for both Insec and Korn.
We did see that identical first ban from Unlimited Potential in game number one. This time, though, they swap out the Shen for a Ryze. So we'll see if they continue to put pressure on that top lane with that last pick, as long as Gnar receiving the respect ban from King.
I also like the fact that Punish's Twisted Fate also receiving a respect ban. Punish is one of the better players, better TF players in the LPL, actually, especially their victory over EDG when they pulled it out as a counter pick to Clear Love's Evelynn.
Last two are going to be Braum taken away from Heart. That was the first priority pick of Unlimited Potential in game number one. Then Kalista from Name, followed up by King, insta-locking Shen for Insect.
So the two big priority picks left out on the field, or I guess I should say three, are going to be Echo, Victor, and Shen. So they decide to prioritize Shen for Insect as opposed to Echo for Hui. Now, Hui did have a fantastic performance in the Lee Sin last game. Unfortunately, wasn't able to connect that one into a win, but this is the thing that I always like to talk about anytime Echo Jungle comes up. MLXG and Amy are the two biggest supporters of Echo Jungle in the LPL, and Echo Jungle has a insane win rate from that position
just
specifically.
Just from those two.
Just from those two. Yep. So, can't let them have it.
These are the guys who are going to make things happen. Currently, Thresh being looked at by Heart, going to steal that away from Zero. We'll see if he decides to commit to it as Unlimited Potential. They've got three games left in the LPL. This is one of them. Thresh locked in. Echo set to match it.
I would expect that they pick up Victor. Nope, never mind. Looks like Korn is going to continue to prioritize. You know, actually, the more that I think about this and kind of reflect, it makes sense. So Azir and Victor are probably single-handedly the two top control mages right now, and it is a very control mage-centric meta. It makes sense to me that Korn would prioritize Azir over Victor just because Azir is going to bring mobility versus kind of the CC utility that Victor is going to have. Not that Azir doesn't have utility, but Victor obviously has more of it. And it just, you know, Korn's a Fizz player. He kind of does his own thing. Like, he's a good player, but he plays for himself, and he doesn't necessarily do the best thing for his team.
Which might be getting into some of the deeper issues about why King have difficulty grouping and fighting as a collective.
No, I'd actually completely agree with that. It's just take skirmish-based champions. Now, typically when they do pick up a Shen, they like to do something crazy level one. They have one of the earliest first blood averages alongside Vici Gaming, who also like to do level one shenanigans. So we'll see if Insect maybe sneaks into the bottom lane. Yep. Flash taunt.
We'll see where he goes in this set. No AD carry yet locked for Skatch as Unlimited Potential. Looking at Punished for Victor. Victor for Punished in the mid lane. And Skatch is going to lock in Maokai for long, and Name insta-locks Lucian.
Last game of the LPL, might as well play Lucian.
Yeah.
One of Name's comfort picks. No surprises right there. He's either going to be Lucian, Kog'Maw, or Jinx, but actually, you could still have a Janna. See if Zero goes Name. Yep, I knew it.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
You just saw his eyebrow go up. He's like, should I? Could I? I could.
His signature champion. Plays a lot of Name. Name obviously synergizes really well with Lucian. If you think back to 2014 summer, when Name and Lucian were all the craze, even bleeding over from Korea into China for the Chinese playoffs when World Elite pulled it out. Oh, come on. I'm just hyping you up. You're Name.
He's going to swap back to it.
He's going to do Nautilus.
I got a feeling.
Name just works so well with Lucian. The double tap on the E, you get all three procs off.
Yeah.
Trading with the W on the Piercing Light.
So he decides to commit to the Nautilus instead. How's that going to work for him?
He's also a great Nautilus. It was typically banned away from him. We talked about how his other big pick is his Thresh, which it should be for every support. But again, putting Zero on a playmaking champion, he's the number one playmaker for King. When things go right, it's typically led by him. And he can solo carry games on champions like Nautilus, like Thresh.
We'll have to see if he's going to be able to carry this one in King. Whether or not they split the series will determine their final placement in the LPL this split. One more point gets them tied back up with Unlimited Potential and Masters 3 at 17 points in the standings for 11th. Though, of course, both World Elite and Unlimited Potential have some more games, so it might not be their permanent position. And King, with last place staring them down, they've got their final roster locked in. Unlimited Potential decide to pick up Ezreal. Oh no, going back to the Twitch.
I was gonna say, Ezreal would be a little bit curious, so again, Skatch deciding to go back to his Twitch. Had a great performance on the last time, though. You know, Braum Twitch versus Thresh Twitch, you have a bit more synergy in proccing Braum's concussive blows. Not that you don't have great kill potential with Thresh being able to CC lock any sort of target with the Flay Death Sentence, but we'll see.
It also provides a solid escape for Twitch.
A lot more mobility for a low mobility carry, yep.
We saw Skatch was basically hunting Khorne around the map. Anytime Khorne showed up in a lane farming, Skatch would immediately dash up there with Heart and sneak in to try to pick him off.
See if he's able to get away with that and find a lead in his lane. However, facing across from Lucian Nautilus, probably one of the most oppressive 2v2 lanes in the game.
Mm-hmm.
That is disgusting.
Can we expect any sort of lane swap to dodge that?
You know, I would like to see a lane swap, but UP, they should have lane swapped last game. They decided to meet Name and Zero head-to-head in the 2v2 bot lane. And I actually don't think it'll change much this time around.
Yeah, that actually went pretty well for King in that early game, getting the really solid early damage. They kept a ton of pressure, but running through the rosters right now in the top lane, it's Insec and Long.
The thing you gotta watch out for is that whenever Insec has Shen, he likes to make a level one play with the Flash Thaunt. Thaunt?
The Taunt. Flash Thaunt.
I wish I could English today.
In the jungle, it's Huey and it's going to be Amy backing him up. Mid laners, Khorne versus Punish with the exact same champion.
See if that matchup goes this time around in Khorne's favor. In the AD carry position, it's Name versus Skatch, Lucian versus Twitch.
And to help it out with the support, you're going to see Zero and Heart.
And again, this is still my featured matchup, the supports facing off.
He missed the perfect opportunity to make a heart with his hands.
I wonder why.
It took me 11 weeks to see that. But we're getting onto the Rift right now. Welcome back, everyone. We have returned to Summoner's Rift. It's week 11, day number 2, set number 1, game number 2, between King and Unlimited Potential.
We talked about this, how King like to make some level 1 shenanigans when they have the Thresh. What do? They group up and they bum rush down bot lane.
They just might be looking for those level 1 shenanigans.
They're playing with Fog of War. The reason why they sent Name up through Tri is because he would walk through a ward. So it's the idea of, hey, it's my AD carry, come look for a death sentence, and then the rest of King would be set up for a flank. But UP, they don't fall for it, and we just trade some deep vision.
Yeah, some wards being dropped out. Looks like Unlimited Potential are going to be the ones who find a few wards. We'll see if they can make any use of this, as once again, Insec looking for something a bit cheesy on the bottom lane. Heart. Whoa, what? Why did he turn around? Flash baited out.
He was trying to dodge.
He dodged into it.
I understand that he dodged into it, but that's why he turned around.
Okay, I see.
He thought that he would throw the skill shot to lead as opposed to just directly at him. But that's the thing about Nautilus, is that his hitbox is so much larger.
Yeah. The dredge line was able to burn the flash out of Heart, and Insec is still waiting down in this bottom lane, so he knows now that Heart doesn't have any sort of flash. Let's see if they can make any sort of advantage happen as both of the junglers start on the bottom side of the map.
The other big thing, though, was the fact that Zero had to start dredge line level 1, which typically on Nautilus, you're either going to take your Titan's Wrath or your Riptide.
Oh, Insec is going to find a double taunt. Skatch is the primary target. The knockup locks him down. Ignite, heal. Oh, first blood picked up by Zero's Ignite Tick hero. Running fast forward. Heart doesn't have a flash. They're trying to save him with the parallel convergence. Ooh, stun finds Insec and Zero, but Heart gets out.
The reason why King are being so cautious right here is because look at where Huey and Khorne are positioned. They're just not in posture to assist, whereas Victor's Punish got over there way quicker.
Ooh, another flash gets burned, this time Long dodging the dredge line of Zero. And a lot of summoner spells missing. King, is this the snowball that they needed in game number 1?
yes, but this is so obvious. King do this every single time. We talked about this in Champion Select. So you know that UP have to expect that level one, Insect's going to be bottom lane looking for that taunt.
Yeah, unlimited potential just not playing to King right now, and it did end up hurting them in this early game.
And unfortunately, for long, he didn't even get anything out of it. So the fact that Maokai started, because they didn't know if it was going to be a lane swap or not, started with double jungle, which makes sense because he can clear camps fairly well with his saplings, as opposed to being in the lane and soaking up more EXP, meant that, yeah, Insect wasted all of, not wasted, but spent all of that time during level one getting Name an advantage. But he didn't lose anything to long because Maokai wasn't absorbing the top lane.
Large wave on the top side of the map means that Long is going to get an opportunity to shove Insect under his turret, but Tui is on that side of the map with his blue buff should any sort of action break out. Sketch trying to catch up with CS, should be able to get most of these minions, but that early first blood onto Heart in the assist. Whoa, Hook finds Name. He's got no exhaust, no flash, taking a lot of damage. He's burned low, forced to dash out, burning his heal to escape, and Zero trades it off.
There's a very famous Thresh player in North America's Challenger scene, the RNG Thresh player, Romelia. Mm-hmm. And she says that the sure way to hit the Thresh hook, and she plays like only Thresh, is to walk forward and then at a 90 degree angle throw the hook behind the creep wave just because the hitbox is larger that direction. And that's exactly what Heart just did there.
The horizontal width of the hitbox?
Yeah, yeah. Like, that's watch her do it. She does it every single time. But Heart just did it to Name. Just you step forward, because normally you lead with Flay, because Flay will guarantee you the death sentence.
Yeah. Interesting. Tui looking for a gank in the top lane. He's letting Insect shove this up, make sure that vision is cleared. We'll see if Long can figure out that he is going to start taking some pressure. Hui's actually wasting a lot of time up here.
The 30-second Long Kong. What is he planning to do? You can't dive a Maokai. He thinks that Insect's gonna get ganked. But Echo, Amy is sitting back in Fog of War waiting for a lantern.
He's actually heading down to the bottom lane now, Amy. Playing the con on the other side of the map.
He's got a bit more room, however, just because the wave is going to
That sounds fun. Zero. Hook. Ooh, he's going to miss. Zero did not want to follow that.
Yeah, I was going to say, he actually should have let that hit him, like you said, because then Zero would have been that much closer to Echo. But fortunately for him, he misses his skill shot.
Name looking to interrupt some recalls. Does succeed for Skatch just by scaring him away, but no crazy action breaking out. Heart and Amy actually going for a nice stroll through the jungle.
They're able to do this because they see that Punished is alone in the mid lane, so knowing that even if they walk into Hui, that they have the numbers advantage because they have their mid laner available, whereas Hui does not.
Here's Korn. Smite is going to secure the gold for Amy. Hui's in a bad spot. He takes a lot of damage. He goes down, but Amy's in even worse position. He's locked down by the Emperor's Divide, gets dropped by Korn. Zero. Tanking up, he's buying some time for Korn to catch back up. There's no Emperor's Divide. Punish has got his flash. He burned his ghost. The ignite is ticking away. Zero just needs a little bit more, but Heart with the body block. Flash auto is not enough for Korn.
Forces the response flash out of Punish, however, so we'll see if they're able to follow up on that just because Azir will have a natural built-in gap closure, whereas Victor is very low mobility.
See if they can capitalize on that a little bit more.
Zero canceled his auto attack. I'm fairly certain. I wish I could see a replay of that. I think he canceled his auto attack, which would have at least given him the stagger proc on Victor to possibly get another stance over attack.
Drops an ambush in the bottom lane, but doesn't quite find Name in 4-0, using it to farm for now as he builds up towards his Blade of the Ruined King. Name with his recall. Actually picks up a second Doran's Blade and some more sustain.
Double Doran's, when you don't want to lose lane ever.
Yeah. He's keeping even in CS with Skatch for now, so. Want to keep track of his progress. While in the top lane, the Wet Noodles continue to, what do Wet Noodles do when they fight? Do they fight? Do they duke it out?
I never understood why the analogy for toppling was the wet noodle fight.
Because a wet noodle is useless. Have you ever been in a pool and like two people have a wet noodle and they just kind of swing them around?
In my pools, they had those little foam noodles that they floated on. Those guys actually hurt. We do have a CS advantage, however, for Insac. Likewise, he has his Stand United available, does not have the TP, but he can follow up on long should they try to make a play across map.
I feel like wet noodles are more wiggly.
I would more call it like a Clash of Titans.
But neither of them are doing anything.
They're still big guys.
They're farming. He's sowing his seeds right now so that he can farm his crops.
Well, he's sowing his seeds and he's got 20 CS advantage on long, which, I mean, he's going to farm that crop.
If anything, he's hoeing long. Because he's getting a larger yield.
Hold on, punish. Find it if he finds.
Yep, there's a laser there.
He wants the blue buff.
Those wolves are certainly
this
still
is
in
so
the
so risky. They have no idea. Oh, it's because they spotted Akwe on the dragon vision. I was going to say, that's so risky. Look at where Shen is. Look at where Maokai is. Now back to me. if Shen
Maokai
decided...
Maokai is now dying.
If Shen decided to collapse right there, if they didn't know exactly where Huey was, that's a 3v2 at best.
Risky play pays off for unlimited potential.
Yeah, because they get the blue buff.
Still 1,000 gold behind, however.
Still got the blue buff.
Name starting to build up a pretty big CS advantage, but a big wave is prepared. Huey looking for some action with Insect. Perhaps trying to find Long, but he's just expecting a counter tank.
Yeah, I don't know why either of the junglers are playing so much to the top side of the map, especially because bot side has so much kill pressure on either side. You've got Lantern Ganks available from Heart. You have just the raw damage output from Nautilus Lucian.
Yeah, it's a patient game. You know, it's King's last game in the LPL.
I was actually expecting Poppy.
They want to go out with a bang. Well, that was last week. But this week is actually their last week.
Zero is setting up a bit for a flank, however. Does not have ultimate available. That's pretty massive, especially because Skatch and Heart both have level 6.
Some scary trading. Insect. Slight health advantage over Long, but the Catalyst just procs, so Long is going to get some health back. Amy's on the top side of the map as well.
Just be careful to step forward into that brush. If not sure if he knows it's... No, he definitely doesn't know it's warded.
Now Insect knows that there's an Echo up there.
King goes on to Dragon immediately, so with the vision granted of Echo in the top side of the map, King are going to go ahead and pull the trigger on this Dragon.
Amy running as fast as his Echo legs can carry him, but probably not going to make it in time. Rest of Unlimited Potential know that this is happening. Recall completed from Insect.
Here comes the TP.
Oh, the hook goes in. Will they be able to secure it? No smite for Huey, but he still manages to get it with Name. 4-0 is already dead. The teleport gets dropped. It's chaos for King, but they're able to keep themselves together. No, they've lost Huey. It's 3 versus 5 now that Amy's joined the battle. Name gets caught. Korn forced to flash the wall. What was a good idea has suddenly become absolutely tragic. Insect joins the fight. Name's going to end up going down, but it's 4-3.
Unlimited Potential will gladly take that trade over the dragon. So yes, they lose the initial control, but they should be able to collapse onto the mid lane and at least siege up onto this tower or do some significant damage. Or maybe they'll just calm. There he goes. I was going to say, where is my laser punish? Because I don't have any mana.
He's looking for the cooldown, but minion wave gets shoved out. Amy gets to clear a ward. Well, know that he spotted by the ward, but not do anything about it.
And no significant damage to the tower, so they just take the kill gold.
That is actually pretty important for Unlimited Potential, because that does put them in the overall gold lead.
It's important because majority of the kills went onto that Victor, punished his mid lane. He now has the Morelos completed.
From the early game, King not quite finding the snowball they needed, despite Name and Zero helping to secure first blood.
This happens every time to King. They just You give them a skirmish, you let them do something sneaky. They can pull off some picks, but as soon as it comes to an arena, the Dragon Pit, a 5v5, wet noodles.
Wiggling around.
Just slapping each other.
That's more appropriate, because wet noodles slap.
No, they don't.
Yeah. Have you? Well, you've been hit by a wet noodle. It's just like, whack. I think that's more of the sound effect. A THWACK.
Speaking of CS discrepancies.
Or it's more like a thunk or a thud. Because, like, you could get a glancing blow.
Name has, what, 20 CS over Scatch? Insec has 20 CS over Long.
The farm down here is rocking that CS lead, but despite those advantages, they're not quite able to make anything happen. Flash death sentence goes wide. Hart tries to pull the Remelia, ends up not pulling anything.
It's okay, Zero immediately missed his skill shot as well. Both Amy and Punish will walk out of that one. Obviously, Hart's trying to pull the trigger because he saw that Punish was making the roam. We talked about the fact that Punish has the CDR and the Morels available, so has the advantage in that specific 1v1 matchup against the Nashor's Tooth Azir. Being able to shove him in, see if he can create some more space for him as he's now rotating top lane. This is exactly what I was talking about, the fact that he just walks into lane, lasers it, and then tries to make something else happen.
Well, there's the laser. Let's see if he can make this something else. Long doesn't have his flash. Insect over
mid.
The wall in the mid lane. Korn is going to get an opportunity to shove up with Huey, and they take the mid tier one.
So, Punish
in the bottom lane. Name goes low. He's still alive. They manage to drop Scatch. Oh, the Insect shield keeps him alive. Hart's not going to find it. Insect with the assist.
Insect a little bit delayed on its Stand United right there. Was probably trying to get away from Long so he wouldn't be able to cancel the Stand United. That said, leaving the top lane. We'll see if Long's able to make anything. No, he's got no minion wave.
I like to think he was trying to make it more dramatic when he did save it.
Or maybe there was just like a miss. Communication.
I got it. I got it. I don't got it. I don't got it.
What I was going to say, though, is
Huey.
Long goes down. He's dead. He's got red buff. Is Punished is doing his best Twisted Fate impression on Victor. You notice this? He just wants to clear waves and then roam around the map, but he doesn't have a destiny.
I feel like when he upgrades his Hex Course, he should play a Twisted Fate for Shannon Gold. Yeah, so he's trying to make some plays across the map.
But he sacrificed his map pressure and his mid lane pressure because of it. So by continually clearing the waves and then attempting to either run bottom and then clear wave, immediately run top, Azir was able to just siege up this tower and open up the map, which is going to be pretty massive in a minute 30 when this next dragon is coming up.
No boots yet out of Horn. So he's going to have to run around the good old-fashioned way. Did mention that dragon up now in a minute and 10 seconds. A lot of vision coming out from King on that side of the map. Name and Zero actually head top. They might try to take this tier one, but here comes UP.
Should be noted that Name has completed his Infinity Etch. So again, we talked about how typically the AD carry build is to go pickaxe into BF sword. Upgraded tier 2 boots, you're going to be sieging up to towers, but knowing that this dragon is coming up in 48 seconds, he itemizes for the team fight, picks up the crit stat, so this tells me that King should be looking for the 5v5, which to me only spells disaster for them.
Yeah, we've seen how it works out for them in the past. Only about 2,500 gold ahead right now. Name, doesn't quite get the double tap on so long. Again, four members of Unlimited Potential on the top side. Insec trying to bully Scatch away, ends up taking more damage than he deals by diving under the turret. Dragon's about to spawn, but nobody's prepared for it.
It's fine because UP also haven't prepared for it. That said, they do have a numbers advantage in the fact that Long has the teleport available. Hart is, however, still up in the top lane, assisting his troop.
Trying to break down the turret, but he's not quite able. Amy looks like he might be the one to pull the trigger. He's going to be spotted out by a pink ward. And Insect with his recall heads down to the bottom lane. Huey finds Hart. Lay knocks him back. Zero looking for the auto attack. Death charge culling. Name gets the kill. feel?
That was actually really interesting in terms of interaction. Using the animation of the Dragon Rage kick on top of the animation of the play to kind of cancel out the knockback. It's still applied a little bit, but I think it has an actual name for Dota. Like a bicycle.
Animation cancel?
No, it's not an animation cancel. It's where you cancel a CC effect or a displacement effect through the animation of your own attack. So, like, if Taric stuns Caitlyn right as she uses her Piltover Peacemaker, the stun duration... I mean, effectively, you're still stunned.
That has to do with the cast on. Like, that's the same thing when you stun Ezreal, but he's still Arcane Shifts away.
Yeah, no, I understand. It's just, I thought it had a specific name from Dota.
It's called, Dang It, Why Didn't I Stun Him? I'm pretty sure that's what Hart was thinking.
Dang it, why didn't I stun him?
So, the trade is going to be for a kill and the top tier 1 turret. Actually, the last tier 1 turret for Unlimited Potential for that dragon. Overall, net gold gain for King, but that dragon number 1, very important to Unlimited Potential.
But again, we talked about how normally Name will itemize for BF Sword Pickaxe and upgraded tier 2 boots if he's going to push down towers versus a team fight. He goes for the Infinity Edge, he's set up to team fight, and King just sacrificed their positioning on the map and gave up another free dragon.
Another miscommunication for King. Might be the last one of the LPL in 2016. We'll certainly have to find out. The game is young.
The night is young.
Yeah. Still a lot of time left on the clock. We're looking to break the world record for the longest game right now.
You think that one will go this long?
86 minutes? 87?
Oh, I don't know how long. Was that the first game?
Yeah.
It was Rib and Kobe, wasn't it?
Yep.
What legends?
No. By about minute 75, they were just screaming, end the game! I need to use the bathroom! And then they started guessing, like, what happens if it hits 100 minutes? Do you think a meteor will come down and just end the game for them? It got wacky.
This game still has a lot of room left to run on it, especially because we have yet to break the first ring of towers for Unlimited Potential,
yep.
Whereas King has successfully broken through that, but now need to attempt to siege onto the second tier towers, which they should be looking at the mid tower as well as the top tower. They're invading and challenging this red buff right now because it's very important that they apply deep vision through this side of the jungle.
Drop. Amy finds the stun onto Huey. He's taking a lot of damage. Insect tries to keep him alive. He succeeds. Horns, Emperor's Divide doesn't find anyone. Punished. Takes a knockup. Amy dodges back into the fight. Gets executed by Huey and Korn. Name trying to kite it around, but he only finds Long. He's at such low health, but he's still alive. Ignite is burning away, but he might end up surviving this as the rest of King try to kite Unlimited Potential back. Oh, a great dodge from Insect is going to pick up the kill onto Punish.
King finally find a 5v5 advantage right there. Now, naturally, they do have a gold advantage for them. I actually believe that Punish was a little bit late to that fight initially.
Yeah.
So, but you know what? I'm going to give it to him. Good job. Name did manage to flash into, I think, 3 people before
yeah.
immediately regretting his decision.
The flash heal dash. This is a great idea. This is a terrible idea.
Doesn't matter. Was carried through. Amy also got the red buff before dying, so I'm going to give him points as well.
But he did give the kill over. I think it was Huey. No, Korn got it.
Yep.
Azir soldiers don't apply it?
I don't know.
Oh, no, Huey. No, he doesn't. That's a Vision play. Well, Unlimited Potential don't find the fight that they're looking for. In fact, it's King who do. They don't find the deep wards they were looking for either, but decide to give up on that side of the map with a big wave bottom. They might look for some pressure on the next tier 2.
They've got great control. Excuse me. King have great control over the deep vision in Unlimited Potential jungle. Amy finds Huey, don't know if he actually wants this one.
Whoa, knocks him over the wall. But, oh man, Amy, this makes him look like a fool. Insect teleporting the ward, finds Skatch. Let's see if he can't pick up the kill before the ambush goes
there
off. No,
Baron.
He's kiting it around. Punish actually manages to net a kill onto Zero, while the rest of King are, in fact, are on the Baron. Insect now there to tank it up. Emperor's Divide buys them some time. Skatch looking for the poison over the wall. Doesn't find it. He almost is going to get a kill. King are like fish in a barrel right now. They've got nowhere to go. Name jumps over the wall for Skatch, but gets executed. And Ace for unlimited potential.
Okay, so this fight started with Huey finding Amy. Thought he would style on him, kicked him into the Baron pit. It was like, hey, why I'm here and Echo is so low health, let's turn on Baron. That was incredibly obvious, says Unlimited Potential. They walk over to the pit and, like you said, fish in a barrel. Just get shredded through by Skatch's rat-a-tat-tat.
Yeah, so much damage coming across from Skatch's hero. Dancing as best he can. The rest of his team is still dead. They might be able to take this tier two.
Because why not?
Hook is going to find Punish. Zero's kiting it around. Insect manages to join up with him. Cannot quite keep up with Punish. And Zero keeps on dancing. He can dance if he wants to. He can leave his friends behind. Because if friends don't dance, and if they don't dance,
they're not no friends of mine. And I'm homebound.
I kept on looking for like a way, because safety is a six-letter word, but both King and Zero are four letters.
I don't know what goes through your mind.
So I could have done like KKKK, GGGG, ZZG, EER, King, Zero. There it is.
There we go, Dragon. So King did manage to get the first Baron. All that really got them, though, was global gold from the objective itself before they were then immediately aced. They managed to secure their second tier tower because Skatch decided that he really wanted to go top lane and attempt to push down the top tier tower, which he still hasn't got.
Yeah.
It's a work in progress. But it's okay, because in the end, King got the second Dragon.
Yeah. Hour two.
This all happened in 2 minutes.
Yes. King now only back up to about 3,000 gold, but it's about to become 2,000.
He got it.
Turret number one, number two secured by Unlimited Potential.
King. He should have just been mid lane with them when they were initially diving when Zero decided to ult onto.
What an excellent idea. Let's go back in time and tell them that. Ooh, Heart giving us a little head wiggle for the camera.
There's been a lot of dancing this game. It's last game
for King. For King.
They just need to finish strong, boys. You got it. 41k. They have the lead.
Moderately. For now.
That counts.
They do have two dragons to one, and
they've got this.
They had the Baron.
Skirmish thing going, where if they just split fights in half.
Do they know that, though?
They've got this skirmish thing going, where if they just split fights in half, they're actually going to be decent, whereas Unlimited Potential, obviously, they want to be grouped up in a big 5v5, creating space for that rat-a-tat-tat, using the parallel convergence layered onto Gravitation Field, Chaos Storm, Vengeful Maelstrom, rat-a-tat-tat.
You know it's a tough game when we watch Echo take the Scuttle Crab. Because it's the most exciting thing happening on the map. Ooh, Skatch, he's taunting. Oh no, he was clearing a ward.
Well, the thing is the easiest tower for Unlimited Potential to siege is this bottom tier tower, which is why you see a collective of red and blue dots now descending. I want to say ascending. No, descending atop.
They're going to the bottom side of the map.
Yeah, but it's a flat plane. Here we go.
Oh, Yui looks for the insect, finds a death sentence instead. He dodges out, still has his dragon raid, but.
But classic King, what are they doing? They send insect to the opposite side of the map, and he's going to split push, because this is how they win games.
Yeah, he's looking for the tier two right now. Unlimited Potential actually have to back away.
Get in there.
Talisman of Ascension gets burned. They're looking for Long. They found him indeed. It's going to take a long time to drop his health.
What?
Name in the front line. Insect trying to join up the Culling. Manages to get the execution. Insect misses his Shadow Dash. He finds only a stun instead. Zero is dead. 4v4. And Unlimited Potential are chasing. Huey, takes a laser. So too does Korn, but he might just make it out.
That was the greatest Emperor's Divide I have ever seen. I'm pretty sure he mowed the entire lawn with that. And hit nothing else. Not a single champion, not a single creep.
Just making sure he's got safety in that bush. But King, get out with their lives. Unlimited Potential still stands strong on the bottom side of the map.
The siege continues.
It does indeed.
Will they get the first tier bottom tower? Can King hold them off? Here comes the teleport.
Next time on Dragon Ball Z.
Long is in base. He's healed up. Also has TP. Could look for the counterplay.
Yeah, let's see if he decides to commit to it as Insect still sitting at full health.
One day.
Yeah, seems like they're just content to dance around.
They just want this tower so badly.
Yeah, they don't seem to be finding it though. Name completes his recall along with Horn. Wave clear? I'm pretty sure.
Pelo convergence, here comes
the
dive.
That was the wave clear that they wanted. The tier one takes some damage.
He's got the zone. We got it, boys.
Goes down.
Okay, Insect looking for the flash taunt. Doesn't have flash, has flash. Three man taunt.
He's looking for it. Oh, he finds punished instead. The hook brings him back in. Korn finally manages to catch up. He picks up a kill, though. Yui's already dead. Long teleports in. Once again, the lawn has been mowed. That is the cleanest lawn ever. Zero picks up a kill. Korn deep in enemy lines. Amy backs out, and King might be able to take this teamfight. He's looking for Amy. Can't quite find it. Long is dead, and yeah, Amy goes down. Ace for King.
Ace for King. They find the advantage on the 5v5, mostly on the back of Insect with that flash taunt onto Victor, trying to delete him. And again, Korn, another fantastic Emperor's Divide. I don't know how he does it.
Netting yet another clean lawn is a vital part of maintaining.
He didn't even split the fight, Zeta. He literally just pushed the Emperor's Divide into the wall. There wasn't anyone.
So the tier 2 turret is taken by King. They lose a tier 1, but take a tier 2 in reverse.
Oh, I'm so glad we have a replay of this. Okay, watch this Emperor's Divide right here. There's Amy. He's going to get on top of Insect. Completely misses everyone. He was trying to aim for Heart. Heart's been losing weight. Didn't even touch him. But after that, they just...
Name and Korn have enough damage to make up for the lack of the Emperor's Divide landing, however, and they are able to end up winning the ace.
The big thing is the fact that, thank you, producer, for giving me a replay of that. The big thing is that Victor was the initial target taunted.
Yeah.
And that they were able to remove Punish, whereas Azir was still able to get out the sustained damage with his Sand Soldiers instead of his Emperor's Divide damage.
Oh, Name almost takes a stun from Amy, but Baron and Dragon have spawned. Insect already on the other side of the map, but unlimited potential might collapse.
They just need to buy time for Insect. Long doesn't have teleport. Insect has the Stand United, so King are in the advantage here positionally just because of their global presence. Just chase them. Literally, just chase them. There they go.
Yeah, it seems like they're going to kite forward now. Insect looking for the inhibitor turret. Parallel convergence. Long is going to be caught. He takes a stun. The shield soaking up. Again, he mows his lawn, but this time it's the river. The AoE gets dropped all across. Name and Korn in the back. Amy right in the front line. Yui dashes in, and King are cleaning up once again. Punished and Long are dead. So too is Heart. Skatch running for his life, but Lucian is on the hunt. Oh, they found him. Oh, poor guy.
That was much better from Korn this time around. Yes, the Emperor's Divide didn't connect with anyone, but it split the fight. It guaranteed safety. And Lucian and Azir were able to continue to output damage from behind the safety of the Emperor's Divide.
They are going to attempt the Baron right now. Amy waiting in the wings. Doesn't have flash or his ultimate.
He's got E. That's all he needs.
Does have a smite. Oh, no. It's down to 1,300 health. The Baron is secured. A little bit too late there, Amy. Empowered recall against Korn. Back to safety.
He was just trying to do that blind. We do have another replay. So again, just watch how this fight. They decide to pull the trigger right now. The Emperor's Divide comes out, doesn't connect with anyone. But look, Lucian and Name, or Name and Korn, just from behind the barracks of the Emperor's Divide wall, are putting out continuous damage. So beautifully placed. Blue team.
From here, Name executes Skatch. And, you know, we talked about the fact that King need a snowball in order to win. Well, it seems like they're actually team fighting and participating rather well. Name and Korn are doing some serious damage. Korn 7-1-8, 5-2-10 on Name. Long caught out of position. Oh,
kicks him
away from the lantern.
Yeah, off the lantern. That was really nicely played. Yeah, suddenly King just feel alive, much more cohesive as a team. And you look at their composition, nothing really changed. You have Name treated his AD carry, now playing Lucian this game. But more importantly, Insect playing the Shin versus the Hecarim. Shin and Hecarim both have great team fighting powers. It's just different how they interact with each other. And the fact that Insect has played far more Hecarim than Shen, he is a far better Shen than he has ever been Hecarim.
Yeah, he's playing exceptionally well this set, involved in 17 of his team's kills. Been all over the map. The inhibitor is broken. Nearly a 9,000 gold lead for King, and they are so tanky. Insect, Huey, and even Zero.
Got the second Baron this time around, didn't get Ace in full control, and they've now surpassed that 10k gold mark. So in true fashion, King are looking to split this series.
Oh, I don't know. King do?
Oh, they split.
Yeah.
How'd Vici do?
They just might. Oh, they split. Hey. What? 33 minutes in, still an opportunity for Unlimited Potential to get back into this.
They do have the wombo combo composition. Again, you can never discount the Venn diagram of murder between Victor and Echo. We used to say this all the time, how if you saw an Echo priority pick, that you almost had to pick Victor on second rotation because you could not afford those champions to be on the same team. But UP, they have all of the cards, 80 on one of his signature jungle champions since the change of the center hole, and not making it count.
Yeah, it's not being as effective as you would hope. After a very passive early game, this game has exploded into typical LPL fashion into a complete slaughter.
Welcome back to the LPL.
Yeah.
It's been a while, Insect.
34 minutes in, King lead with the bottom inhibitor down. Pretty moderate gold lead up to 11,000 now that they're up. Amy, once again, looks to secure the scuttle grab.
Chinese Twitch is pretty good.
Pretty awesome.
Have you ever heard Korean Lissandra?
I've not.
She sounds like a tennis player.
Okay. Tossing balls across the field.
But I'm pretty. But I almost feel that Chinese Twitch is better.
It actually sounds like what I would expect Twitch to sound like. But King, sieging in the mid lane. They expect Twitch not to be making any sounds because they expect him to be dead as they look for the siege.
They also have a pink ward placed, so they should be sieging here for a while patiently while Insect creates another pressure point on the bottom side of the map. Again, has the stand united as well as his teleport available. He's also about, you know, 4 feet away from them.
Yeah.
Let them defend that pink ward.
Catching the ward, the minions as well. Hook finds Heart, Zero diving deep. Insect drops the stand united. The channel gets canceled, but he's still right in the front lines. Amy dodges the shadow dash, but Huey looks for the kick, Sketch finds a knockup. Name destroys him with a huge crit, flashes the wall into two, gets destroyed by Punish. That's the trade, AD carry for AD carry.
The arrogance immediately punished right there. Name flashes the wall, Punish says, "What's up, mate?" Deletes him from the game.
Oh, they might get the inhibitor. Insect takes a stun. Dealing some damage. Whoa, Korn, what are you doing? You're out of mana. Oh, no, that was not the play he was looking for. King are scattered, but they're still picking up a kill. They trade it over. Punish goes down for Huey. Zero locked against the wall is going to end up dying, too. Stun finds him, and they net him.
The instantaneous regret of Korn right there.
Yeah.
Looking for the Azir Sack, gets in deep. He's between five members of the enemy team and says, wait a second.
Uh-oh.
I don't have enough mana for this.
That awkward moment when ka-chee, 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 ka-chee. No mana.
And let's not, you know, never mind.
Discredit Unlimited Potential.
UP played that well on the dive, but there was no reason for King to dive then. They just had to wait.
In good old King fashion.
Which is why I use the word arrogance.
Yes.
Yeah.
Still about a 10,000 gold lead, and the bottom inhibitor is cleared. Middle inhibitor, completely bare, and a lot of vision on top of it. So they know how much health the inhib has. The answer is full.
Dragon will be spawning in 50 seconds. This will be fourth dragon for King, second dragon for UP, depending on which team. More importantly, though, Baron in 1 minute, 10 seconds. See if King can end the game on a third Baron.
Oh, boy. Korn does not, in fact, have Baron right now. Neither do the rest of King. That is, in fact, a visual bug.
No, actually, King just needed the assistance. They have a permanent Baron through the course of the game, because that's the only way this is ending.
Oh, boy. Name, once again, looking for an arrogant play. Huey, looking for long.
He's got flash.
I don't think that's an arrogant play. I think that Long is just lost.
In his own jungle, Amy looks for Yui now. He's overextended, kicks Amy away, dodges the stun, but no follow up.
Dragon spawning in 10 seconds. They should be able to fall back on that, especially with UP being low health in their top laner and secure that next objective. Oh, never mind. They could just farm. No, they're splitting.
Yeah, they're looking for the dragon right now. That's number 4 for King being secured.
In sec.
Don't encourage him.
Oh, my God. I love doing that with Tahm Kench. Because he makes the weirdest sounds in his auto attack animation.
I love Thompson's auto animation.
Oh, siege begins again. Korn putting the ascension of Karima.
You know, now I'm just disappointed in both these teams. King, this is your last game in the LPL. You could have played Tahm Kench.
Hey, we might see it yet in the LLSPL and LPL promo. Whoa, Heart.
Whoa, Heart indeed.
Yeah.
He's trying to get him.
He is indeed. Baron already secured by King. Insect finds the taunt onto Heart.
So that is the real Baron buff.
Hook will secure Heart. And
you know, despite his Banshee go?
Yeah, lots of damage being ticked across. Name and Korn trying to kite it out. Death Sentence's dodge. King split on the opposite side. Yui gets a lot of damage from Punish. He goes down. Knock up. He's going to find Amy. Chrono Break keeps him alive. Long, again, still in the front line, tanking quite successfully. Korn, Zonya's to knock out of the stun. Name still kiting around the far side. Korn is low. He goes down. Name face to face with Skatch. He crits not once but twice, but it's not enough. Skatch survives and Punish puts an end to that. Zero takes a laser. Ace for King.
And somehow King lose that fight. Did you look at Korn the entirety of that fight? He was zoning off three members of Unlimited Potential before finally getting flashed on and going down. I'm actually confused how King lost that.
Interesting play from King, and Unlimited Potential coming up big in that set is going to bring it to about a 7,000 gold difference now from the 10 that there was prior. The inhibitor has respawned, and you know, King do have that fifth dragon they can fall back on.
Oh, thank goodness.
And yeah, and the fourth Baron. Also, look at Victor's AP right now. 857.
That's how they lost that fight.
Wow.
I was looking at Korn zoning off, Punish, Skatch, and I think Amy. He forced the Echo ultimate out.
Yeah.
And it was just these Sand Soldiers ripping through them. Like, okay, you know, King's got this. Korn zoning off all of their carries. And suddenly, what is happening right now?
Then suddenly punished.
The power of Victor, and again, it comes back to it. UP have an amazing 5v5 composition. They're an amazing 5v5 team. Not the best in LPL, but one of the top 5v5 teams. Mm-hmm. And you had Baron, and you have Shiv, and you're really good at split pushing. Why? Why are you fighting?
They're going back to it now. Looks like Insect heading to the top lane. Rest of King now in the mid lane, but they've got to keep an eye on Fire.
Remember that Xiaogu game? Against OMG.
Out of all 44 that they've played?
The one that we did yesterday.
Against OMG? Yeah.
It's kind of how I feel like this is going to happen.
We're going to get to 56 minutes. We're still trying to break that record for the longest game in the LPL. We successfully broke it yesterday. We'll break it again today. And then a third time tomorrow.
It was the longest game of the season. I don't think it's been the longest game of
history of the split of the LPL. Yes, I should clarify.
But right now we're in a very similar situation. King cannot 5v5.
Yeah.
This, unless it's perfect. Like, Huey needs to get the best possible insect of either Skatch or Punish. And at this point, I would just say Punish has to die first. If he doesn't, UP win the fight.
He doesn't even have a Zhonya's.
Who needs a Zhonya's when you have 800 AP and you laser across 5 people and just watch them explode into shrapnel?
That's a strong laser to turn people into shrapnel.
Victor's an amazing champion. He's really good in lane phase. He has an incredible mid-game power spike, and then he gets to hyperscale into late game with a bunch of utility and CC.
The Technoturgy.
Gets all of his evolution points when he's in upgraded hex core. His gravitational field becomes a little mini Orianna ult.
He's pretty strong.
Pretty good champion.
That's what I'm getting.
I like Victor. I think he's probably highest priority. We already talked about how Korn, you know, has a natural tendency to pick Azir over Victor.
Yes, just Fizz.
Yes, but this makes sense for Korn. He likes having that mobility, likes jumping around. He likes mowing lawns.
And rivers.
That one was good. You know, I'll point out the questionable, serviceable Azir ults.
Okay.
With that one, that was like hunkered down with Name.
Yeah.
They're keeping UP at bay.
In the bunker.
Yeah. That was good.
1 minute till Dragon 5 is up for King. They've got Insects, Blink Pushing, and Unlimited Potential. Might be looking to put an end to that as they've got three members on the top side of the map.
Other itemizations that we can check in, because we've repeated multiple times how Victor is massive. Name, 7-4-11 on this Lucian right now, has both BF upgrades, the Bloodthirster Infinity Edge, as well as the Trinity Force. I always like Trinity on Lucian, obviously getting multiple Sheen procs very quickly using your double tap passive.
See if he can manage to do enough damage to break through long. This tanky line of this set, Heart, whoa, way overextends. He goes awful low here. Here comes a double teleport as well. Korn drops the Emperor's Divide, but Long's still in the back line. No, he's kiting it out. Let's see if Skatch can try to turn this around. As Punished is a little bit late to the draw. He's finally going to catch up, takes a lot of CC. There goes the ult, but is he going to drop it down? It's
oh, he's been locked
finds
up.
Him. He goes down. Korn trying to drop onto Skatch, but will he be able to pick up the kill? Slides forward. They will get it indeed. Three kills for King.
I think they may have just won the game right now. Fifth Dragon is up and available, but instead they are rushing towards UP's base. They have a sizable creep wave behind them. But more importantly, that was a great ultimate, Korn. Fantastic job again, creating the bunker, letting Name and Korn sit back, continually put out damage. More importantly, Insect found the hard CC onto Punish, removed that Victor from the team fight.
Yeah, they're looking. Nexus turret number one goes down. Heart, the secondary focus is dropped. Amy doesn't have enough. Nexus turret two goes down. King are on the Nexus, and they're going to win the game, splitting the series with Unlimited Potential.
Looked a little bit shaky there, kind of in late mid-game, but King managed to team fight it out on the back of Insect and Korn.
Yeah, amazing play from Name and Korn, trying to stay alive as best they can, but Insect landing the taunt in the thick of things. Finding that pick on the Punish was huge.
We talked about it. If Punish survived from the fights, it was over. UP would just decimate them with the control and spread of Victor. Getting that CC, very necessary. And UP, I mean, they're still tied for last.
They certainly are. So too are King. So they might just end up a little bit better than last. A little bit better than 12th, at least, if they end up tied for 10th, as they currently are. Both World Elite, Unlimited Potential, and King are now tied for that 10th place spot at 17 points. However, both World Elite and Unlimited Potential have more games. WER playing later today, and then again tomorrow, whereas Unlimited Potential are playing WE tomorrow.
Yep, WE have a collective of 6 points up for grabs, whereas UP only have 3 left up for grabs. Again, UP cannot make a race for that top 8 playoff standings. However, they can afford to get themselves a better seed going into the LPL promotion tournament. Now, WE cannot afford to lose any more games. They are the only team left in bottom 4 that still have a chance to make playoffs.
Yeah, they've got 6 points up for grabs. At 16 points, that would put them exactly tied with Masters 3 Insect. Looking for some handshakes, is going to find them before finding his way back into the middle. Final bow comes across for King, as this could be the last time that they bow in the LPL, as they are currently slated for the LPL promotion tournament set to happen early next week.
And again, 4 out of the 5 King members were on the world stage last year. 3 of them in the world's finals last year. What a turn.
Yeah, just not quite finding the synergy. And we actually have a replay of that last fight. We're going to throw it on your screen right now.
We can go ahead and roll it. The thing that you're going to watch here is the Azir ultimate and then the CC chain onto Punish. So Long comes in with the teleport. Immediately, Korn's going to look for the reset to attempt to push him away. It's fine, though. Long actually twisted advances out of it. Insect is now in the thick of things, but he's so tanky that they just can't cut through him. But here comes that taunt right across Punish, and then Korn just cleans up the rest of this fight.
Yeah, and with both Punish and Skatch dead, it was nothing but mopping up for King to end up finishing off the series and taking the eventual win.
Still very messy. I mean, that said, last game, obviously you can't say, you know, what were the the true intentions of all the players, you know, where their heart's into it. We saw yesterday that Royal truly never gave up when they had their last game, that they went out fighting, and King likewise decide to split the series, have a great final game, play some comfort champions.
Very solid play out of King, but unlimited potential. They still have an opportunity when they play tomorrow, but we're going to go and take a quick break. Don't go anywhere. Our next match will be right back.